Keep watching Charis TV.
God wants to fulfill His promises.
Take this message
to yourself. God
is fulfilling
my promises. We have been given this to
excel.
God has bestowed His power in us. Are you hearing that verse? So that when we have the power, out of that power, the promises He has promised will be fulfilled. And when those promises are fulfilled, we are able to fight a good fight. Can you see that devil always will love to attach you with something? But we have got power, and also we have got His promises. The power of God makes us to live the life that God wants us to live. Waiting for God to fulfill His promises. Promises that God has promised. They must come to pass in our lives. He bestowed His power in us, so that we live a life of His divine nature. We must not get out of His way when we face challenges. God wants us to live a dynamic spiritual life, waiting for the promises to be fulfilled. Galatians 3 verse
18.
You are called for magnificent promises. Inexpressible
promises.
If truly there are things we need to do to get the promise, it won't be coming from above. What we have to receive from God does not need us to struggle or follow some protocols. We just need to believe what He has promised. God wants you to take what He said. If He said you will prosper, you will prosper. There's nothing that must be done. You must believe the word of God. We need to reach a level where we talk the promise. Even when it's tough, even when the challenge is worse, you tell yourself, I'm not yielding to my challenge. I know what He has promised. Why? Because of the power in you. That power will begin to work to bring the promise He has spoken. You might not be aware you've got power. But listen to this. Speak the promise when you are tough times. You will see the power in you creating the solution you need. If you believe, say amen. Galatians
3 verse 18.
Psalm 105. Let's read verse 42. When God gives a promise, He doesn't forget. We forget because we are looking at what devil can do. 1 Kings. I want to show you 1 Kings, the same verse, chapter 8 verse 56 and 57. You'll be surprised. You'll find that it's the same thing. You need to claim this word. It's God who fought for the people of
Israel
by the word of Moses. When Moses spoke the word, He gave them rest. I don't know if you're hearing
that.
He never allowed any single word to fall to the ground. You know, I want to give you a word. And my word also will never fall. God used Moses. God today will use Makananis. I say, wherever you are facing any challenge, the Lord will open a door for you. I said, the Lord will open a door for you. There is no word that falls to the ground. From Moses,
when he spoke the word,
and spoke the promises, there's no word that fell to the ground. I want to give you that word. I say from today, any prophecies you've been given, it will never fall to the ground. I say it will never fall to the ground. Whoever say God is a liar is about to be surprised of your life. Because he's the fulfiller of his promise. In the name of Jesus. Sometimes we need just to tell you that things will be okay. It will be okay. Doors are open. It will be open. I want to give you this word. This week you are going to come here with a testimony that whoever is oppressing you will surrender in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There is no way you will go and nobody will hinder you. I see breakthrough coming your way. I see breakthrough coming your way in the name of Jesus. Romans 4. Verse 17. God have power to do what he has promised. When you believe the prophecies, you are standing where God is
standing.
You are no longer yourself. You are approved by God. When God approves you, he make you a candidate of what you said. I don't know if you are hearing
me.
Many of us today, we are looking at ourselves, still having some doubts. Listen to this. Challenges must come your way. Problems must come your way. But just stand in the righteousness of God. Be the righteousness of God. By believing in his promise. Can you see when you go out of the way? When you come out of what he has promised, you're no longer a righteous person. There are some things that we normally talk about.
I
need deliverance because I'm facing one
thing.
No. Whatever you are facing,
you
want to change your righteousness. Whatever you are going through, want to deny God. Don't deny God. God, stand in his promises. God cannot lie. He has promised and he will do it. The promises of God here are in front of you. Yes, there's a mountain, but don't think about that mountain. Yes, there's a challenge, but don't think about that challenge. See beyond that challenge. See beyond that mountain. Stop talking about the mountain. But God has promised you a blessing. God is not a liar. Why are you
lying?
Talking about what you are facing. You cannot die until the promises of God are fulfilled. Listen to this. It's what devil is doing. He tried to fight you. He tried to put you down.
Hey,
look at him. He will say, oh, not this one. Because there's a promise of God upon your life. When you look at him, they see Jesus. They don't see you. When you are facing them, it is not you. You are defeated. But look at the enemy. The enemy will say, hey, it's not this one. This one is untouchable because of the promises of God. And the promises of God are true and are faithful, and they will come to pass in this person. People are looking at you. They say you are a failure. They are not looking at your face. They are looking behind you. This is the time that people have to look at your face.
Look at your face.
Hey, they will see Jesus. They will see, hey,
Someone knows you by the past. He does not know you by the future. Someone knows you by what is happening to you. He does not know you by what God wants to do in your life. I don't care what devil is saying, but as the promise of God upon your life, and I'm here to tell you that God is about to do something. God is about to change your situation. God is about to lift you. God is about to raise you. God is about to lift you. It is your time. It is your time. You cannot fight there. It is your time. You cannot suffer there forever. It is time for God to advertise you. It is the time for God to speak your name. It is the time of God to touch your life. Promises.